This is a quick review of the STOK Tourist, how do you say it? STOK, STOK Tourist Barbecue. It normally sells, I think, at Target for like $59, but I got it at Home Depot, it was $39. And I thought, wow, this packs up, and I'll show you that in a minute. This packs up so small. It's basically this small, and it's got a little carrying case. I thought it would be perfect for me. So I came out yesterday. And I thought I'd cook something. Of course, the wind came up a little bit, so it was about 3 to 5 miles an hour. And one of the things that's not good about it is, you see the flame right there? Well, the wind just goes right in there. There's nothing blocking the wind from going in there, so it kept blowing the fire out. That's something I do not like. So if there's any amount of wind, of course, I gave up. I still cook something. I put my cast iron pan. What's so neat about it is you can take this part off, and it's just a regular thing that you can put my, you can put your cast iron Dutch oven, which I did. I cut up some onions and some peppers and sliced up a steak really super thin and cooked it on the bottom, and then I took and put it on top of some top ramen. I know, real classy. But anyway, today there's no wind. Well, there's a tiny bit of wind, but I thought I'd come out here and try something. First of all, I have these old bottles. I'll probably die here. These old bottles of Coleman stove, and I think that's from when I went camping with the kids, 30 years ago? So, it was probably pretty old. It could explode and then I would die, but then you wouldn't see this, so if you're seeing it, you know I didn't die. What I did was to cook this. I want to see how long and if it will cook for how long and what I should do, because this was a full bottle. So I cut some potatoes. I didn't fix two, but one's for tomorrow. I cut a tomato up in about that big strips. I put a little butter in there, and I put red onions in there, and I put some salt, seasoning salt on there. And then I cook them. They usually take about an hour. Of course, I don't know how to adjust it, because it doesn't really have an adjuster thing right there. It just says off and on. It is a fire. That is a black circle, meaning off, I guess. Little, big. So anyway, I put that on there. I put this in aluminum foil, and then you see there's a plate there. I mean, there's that thing there that goes around. And supposedly, any grease is going to go around the side like this and come out there in that little drip pan with the hole right there. So that's what I'm thinking is going to happen. So, because underneath that is a big hole, if it goes straight down, then it'll go right on the flame. So that's going to be something to pay attention to. When I put it together, it's pretty easy. It's got a couple screws in there. It was pretty easy. I mean, it wasn't that big a deal. I like the handle because it keeps the heat away from the handle. I thought that was pretty clever. When you fold it up, and I'll show you these, you take that bottle off, and I think it doesn't say anywhere, but I think you can hook up to a regular huge propane bottle if you're out in the road. These fold up. I have to watch this all the time. And since I don't know how hot it gets, I really will have to watch it. But it's kind of nice. It's got an igniter over here. That's just a piece of paper to show you that's an igniter. And it's got several ways to cook it. Well, let me go show you the box. Because this has just got a little thing that holds on there, that flips on there. And I thought, you know, if I put my cast iron pan on here, it's too far away from the heat. So if you're going to cook in a pan, you take this whole part off here. But if you're going to cook a chicken and potatoes, I want to cook a steak on here too. I thought I'd give the... I'm marinating the steak. But I thought I would give the potatoes some extra time, because it seems to me they ought to cook like 45 minutes or an hour, depending on how hot this gets. Total guessing. All right, I'm gonna go show you the box now. Okay, this was the box that came with it. I was gonna show you how to put it together and everything, but it's really not that hard. You can do that. It just read the instructions. I did that for a change. I got, like I said, I got this at Home Depot. So there it is. And there it is on the box. And so what it's telling you here, change the way you grill. Create your own grilling system with custom grill inserts. You can buy these separately too. Now I went online to Home Depot and I couldn't see it anywhere online. I just was in the store and I bought it compulsively because I think I'm going to get rid of my $10 barbecue and my huge barbecue, which I never used for 35 years. So I don't need that big thing in the backyard. And besides, I'm thinking of traveling, so I'm going to need something like this. Okay, so I went in and got the book. And I also went in and got the steak that's been marinating in there. So I'll try to do this one-handed. We'll see. I'm just going to go all out, and if I get it dirty, I get it dirty, I guess. It's kind of weird putting it on top of that. I don't know. The steak, I think, is going to cook first. But we'll see. The thing touches that dirty table, so don't even think about it. I don't like it too bad. Oh, man, this is... Oh, it's getting in the marinade. Oh, it's getting all over everything. Oh my god, it's big. These are two big bacon... Oops, not showing you, sorry. Big bacon potatoes. I'm experimenting. I don't know, I couldn't pass it up. There's only one left. I guess I won't be able to take it back. But see how it goes down on there? Oh, see? It dripped down in that pan right there. Oh, yes! Yes! I don't know. I guess I'll brush the marinade on there or something. All right, I'm going to put the top on and we'll go look at the book. But first, let's assemble it. There's the assembly. And there's the rear leg. It's weird. I just didn't see this anywhere. I got online and I did super research and I just didn't see it anywhere. Okay, so here your legs flip down like that, and you just flip them out. It's like a spring. This cutout tab I couldn't quite figure out, but there's a place for it to go right there. So you put this down. You flip these little things on the inside, and it holds this to this. See, that's how it works. And then, oops, need another page here. And you put that little drip pan on there, and now it's attached, and then you put the bottle in there, and you put the grate in there, and you test it for leaks, which I didn't do, because I've got it outside here, and if it leaks, it'll go in the air, but I did put it on really tight. Now to disassemble it, you take it all apart. You put that on there, and you put the little handy thing on there. And what I did is I took my cast iron pan. I just put it on top of there. You can put like a little one, or yesterday I used my Dutch oven because that's perfect. I didn't put the top on, I just cooked in the Dutch oven. Camp stove mode, that's called, if you take all the stuff on the top off. There's not really a lot to it, but that's it. That's the little case that comes with it, and it's just a tiny little thing when it's all done. No gas. I don't have a sense of smell, so I'd be trouble in there. Gas leak, grease fire. Oh, jeez. I guess they needed to tell me that. If the thing is on fire, what do? Turn the control knob off or run like hell. All right, that's enough of that. I like that little. My whole thing was that I'm trying to think small. Isn't that good? Because this is my old one when I was thinking big. And I don't need that big old thing anymore. I've painted it and fixed it up and... See, this is the stuff that drops from the trees. It's everywhere. Everywhere. And branches were so bad. Alright. Anyway, so nice today. I just had to come out here. I'm cleaning while I do this, so we'll see. Okay, let's check it. It's about halfway done. Ooh, you know what? This is looking good. Burning the hell out of that. I guess that's because of the marinade. I certainly can't take it back now. And the two, I don't know how they're doing, but I'm going to put this down. I just have it all the way up. So if I have it all the way up, I guess that's what's happening. Because the potatoes will take a while to cook. But we'll come back a little bit later. Okay, so all that stuff on there caught on fire. Well, now what do I do? All right, I'm shutting it off. I am such a nut. I'm shutting it off because I don't think that's right. It's called charbroiled. Oh, geez. Now what do I do? I guess I'll take the steak off. Yes. Oh, shoot. What's that? That's a fire. Ooh. Oh my god, doesn't that look good though? Huh? Guess I'll put it back on. How do I know it's done? I don't know. I don't know if it's done or not. Poke it. If it's soft to the touch, no, that's fish. Is the blood coming out? I don't know, it's dark. Ooh. So, no heat. Heat is off. Still burning. Maybe it'll get done quicker this way. Oh no, yellow flame is bad. Oh, but that's not the flame. That's the crap burning on the grill. All right. Maybe I'll take it off. Ooh, it's like a magician. Yeah. There's no leaves on the trees. Well, not many. So I should have a can of spray water, huh? All right. Well, let's put it over here in the moonlight. My pitiful attempt at camping in the backyard. Did you ever notice in a photograph it gets brighter, but in a video it's darker? But anyway, it's still a little raw for me, but I guess it's edible. The potatoes are not even close to being done. I guess I'll just put them in the refrigerator or something. I mean, in the microwave. Or I could go back out there and cook a little more, but the problem with cooking a little more is that thing will start on fire again. Something wrong with this, I don't know, it's me or the grill. We'll see. Well, good morning. This is the morning after the event of fire barbecuing. This is the bottom half. And I just wanted to show you the mess it made. It splattered all over that. And then I noticed on the video when I was editing it, so while I was cooking, the whole thing was leaking at the side. Got on that table. I come out here and clean the whole table. And made pretty much of a mess. So that grease pan didn't really hold it. Now, you know, it's probably me. I shouldn't have done all that marinade and whatever, but I don't know. I didn't read anything about not doing the marinade thing like that. But in any case, that was messy. So then I took the top part off, and it's in the... I just let it soak all night because it was really burnt on there. So I'm going to have to get better at it. And just remember, but if I cooked a whole chicken in there, wouldn't that chicken leak all over too? That is the question. All right. Go in there and look at the other stuff. The other parts that are now totally greased up. Okay, I'm in the house now, and I don't know how you would do this if you were in an RV. First of all, I have a giant stainless steel sink in my house. And I let these pieces soak all night in this big old thing, which I know RVs are much smaller, big old sink. And I scrubbed and scrubbed and scrubbed on this. I still had some more scrubbing to do, but I left some on, but it was solid black like that, of course, because of the marinade. This was hard to clean out, even though I let it soak. I might give it another shot. One thing that I did wrong was I didn't spray Pam on it, and I didn't even spray Pam on the grill. Oh, no. The grill came pretty clean, though. I don't know. This is just too much of a mess. So if I'm going to go camping, I need a big bucket. You can't just disassemble the thing and put it in that little bag dirty, right? I don't know. I have to figure this out. I'm thinking even if I sprayed Pam in there and put a chicken on top of this. It's gonna, grease is gonna get all on the table of where I'm cooking it at, because it was coming out the sides. It wasn't just in that little drip pan. Oh, where's that little drip thing? Oh, here it is. I washed it earlier. It's supposed to all go in here, but it didn't. I don't know. At this moment, I'm thinking, is it me or is it the grill? It seems to be a different. There's two things that I find that are kind of annoying, is that the grease went all over. Even if it did catch on fire and all that, it's still not supposed to go all over the table. And the second thing is, you can't control the heat. I mean, there's no way to, I guess you can, but you don't know where medium is, but you could figure that out. But I think the worst thing about this is that the flame keeps going out. It didn't go out yesterday, but the day before that, and if it's like, you know, 3 to 5 miles per hour, it seemed a little windy on the video, but it really wasn't that windy. Well, that is the conclusion of my test on the STOK, STOK, tourist. I don't know. I'll have to try it again, I guess. My fault, probably.